Good morning, students. I am Rameshwari, JL History, TTWRJC, Girls Narsapur, Medak District. Today, our class, introduction of second year, before getting into the actual syllabus, we look into the syllabus topic-wise and unit-wise that we complete in academic year. The entire second year history covers the history and culture of our complete Telangana from earliest times. The main objective is the account of political, economical, administration, literature and culture of Telangana. The first unit, prehistory and Shatavahanas. We are going to study about Shatavahanas. Shatavahanas period, prehistory, geographical features of Telangana, the age of Shatavahanas. The capital of Shatavahanas and economic religious condition of Telangana in Shatavahana period. The second chapter is the post Shatavahana period. The post Shatavahana period is understand conditions of administration, economy, social, religious sources like languages, literature and art and architecture. Also brief like Vishnukundalis, Ichwakulas, Vishnukundalis and Chalukyas, etc. The third unit, age of Kakatiyas. Kakatiyas age emerged political center and dominant power. Also we will see sources like Thousand Pillars, Motupalli's Charter, inscriptions like Palampeta, Chandupatla, etc. Evolutions of administration, economy, society, religious, languages, and art and architecture. The fourth chapter is Kutub Shahis of Golconda. The age of Kutub Shahis, agriculture, irrigation, trade and commerce, contribution of Kutub Shahis to Telugu literature. The fifth unit, Asaf Jahis. In brief, we will continue Asaf Jahis. Fifth chapter. Sixth unit is land tenure system of Nizams. The land tenure system under the Asaf Jahis is deals with the sixth unit, Safekas, Jagirs, Agraharas, Inam lands. The division of Nizam state, land revenue administration, samsthanas and garis. Unit 7th is modernization of Telangana under Nizams. Development of transport and industrialization. We come across the growth of railways, communication, introduction of modern education. Modern education is covered in this 7th unit. And 8th unit is socio-cultural and political awakening in Telangana. Arya Samaj, Adi Hindu movement and Dalit movement for formation of Nizam Andhra, Andhra Mahila Sabha and Vande Mataram movement. 8th chapter is devoted to the growth of socio-cultural and political awakening of Telangana. It focused on movements launched by Andhra Mahila Sabha, Hyderabad State Congress and leftist forces. We will cover these topics in 8th unit. 9th unit is People's Movement Against Nizam's Rule. We come across the People's Movement Against Nizam Rule, including Telangana peasant armed struggle and tribal revolts, police action, integration of Hyderabad state into Indian Union and formation of Andhra Pradesh. And next 10th chapter is the agitation for separate state of Telangana. The early phase 1969 and 1600 emerged of TRS protest in Andhra region Sri Krishna Committee, protest of Jay Shankar sir and KCR, all protest of Telangana for formation of Telangana state. These are 10 units we will come across in this year. Hope you all do great in second year. All the best. We will start first chapter in next class. Thank you, students.